Dude, it's fucking October. How did this happen? I'm excited.
I'm excited too.
This will be fun. You're the first family member I'm having on this channel. So I've had a couple friends in New York on, but I haven't been anywhere with family.
Ta-da. Months. Do I have red marks on my face from my nap?
Yeah.
Nice. Is it recording already?
Yes.
Oh.
What's up, internet? My name is Savvy. Thank you so much for coming back to my channel. I'm really excited to bring this new Music Friday to you. I've had a lot of requests for different songs on this one, so I'm hoping you guys enjoy it. This week, I obviously have someone else on my channel. Do you want to introduce yourself?
Yeah, I'm Luke. I'm her brother. She's out in Phoenix visiting for a little bit, so it happened to fall on a Friday. So here we are.
Yeah, I'm really excited to be on vacation out here because I literally have not left New York City since COVID hit, and it's just really nice to get away. So, let's get into it. I'm not interested in a long intro today. We've got a lot of music to get through, a lot of music released this week, and a couple from last week that I missed out on, and I just didn't have time to record. So, 10 tracks, let's get it. First track is Lovesick Girls. This is BLACKPINK. This is from their new album that dropped. I kind of want to do a full album reaction to this. I don't know when I'm going to have time to film it, but we'll see.
I haven't even heard of BLACKPINK.
They're amazing. Even like lyrics. I don't know who writes their music. I don't know if they write it or if someone else does. Yeah, so they wrote this with somebody else. But they're really good. Have you heard the song How You Like That? How You Like That?
Maybe.
That's them too.
Oh, okay.
And they just put out a track with Selena Gomez called Ice Cream.
Okay.
It fucking slaps. Cool. It's so good. Very excited to do that album reaction. I feel like that's going to be a lot of fun. Oh,
look at you.
Hey. Okay, next track is Don't Stop. This is Megan Thee Stallion featuring Young Thug. Do you listen to Young Thug?
No.
Yeah, I don't really listen to him either. And honestly, I wasn't even sure if I wanted to put this on the playlist this week, but there were so many people who were like, bitch, you better.
Feel good.
And I was like, I can't not.
Yeah, I might have to start twerking or something.
Giving people what they want.
I don't know. If anybody wants
okay,
that.
Let's do it.
Oh, really abrasive.
Real hot girl shit.
Like real hot girl shit.
Like immediately.
I got a stank ass ball in a reckless ass mouth. Hear my shit so tight. When we fuck my pussy talk.
Oh.
I just tell them what I want. When you say fuck me, I tell them fuck me good. Chase these niggas, I wish I would. That bitch like me, hoes wish they could. She's half with me, I need gas to see. And I'm all in a panic, she a bastard to me. Don't stop, pop that cat. Just like that. Check that shit.
I'm not surprised with this trending.
Don't stop.
I don't, yeah, after WAP.
I don't think I've heard
you said like that.
Sibling. It's just another level.
I clearly don't listen to rap music very much. Because this is very alarming to me. Like,
I like the beat though.
No, I do too. Just
lyrics are throwing me off.
Yeah, a lot. I really don't know what to do right now.
Come on with the outro.
Okay, I like this. This part. This is my favorite part of the song. It's nice. I feel like I just got assaulted. I have no doubt that it's good music. And I'm gonna catch heat. For sure.
I don't think
for
so.
For sure.
I don't think so. I don't think, I mean, you can't hate on people for their preferences of music. I really enjoyed that.
Yeah, I mean, apart...
It wasn't WAP, and I think I definitely enjoy WAP more. I honestly wasn't that impressed with the Young Thug feature, but that's just me. Sorry about it. I had it on the playlist, and then I took it off because I thought it was going to be abrasive.
Well, yeah.
And it was.
Yep, sure was.
But I put it back on because that was good content.
I mean, that was probably pretty funny to watch. Let her know if you enjoyed me cringing.
If you love my brother
for a full track.
Being completely awkward for 3 minutes. Let a bitch know. Next track is Wonder. This is from Shawn Mendes. Shawn Mendes just announced that he has an album coming out on December 4th. Happy birthday to me. My birthday is December 9th, so don't forget. And honestly, as soon as he announced that he was putting out a single and was coming out with the album, I immediately went back to his previous album and was just like, well, this is what I'm listening to today. He made it really clear on his social media, I guess, that this album really means a lot to him. So I'm excited to hear his first single. Okay, all right. I'm here for it.
Yeah.
Come on, with the finger. album.
Yeah.
Give me the album.
Yeah. That's 2020 masculinity
that's,
right
that's
there.
That is 2020 masculinity.
I love that.
I wonder when I cry into my hands, I'm conditioned to feel like it makes me less of a man.
Mm-hmm. There you
Listen,
go.
Listen, Shawn, we're ready. We're ready.
Let's go, bro. I'm excited. I feel like I'm going to listen to so much more music now.
You're welcome. So, the next track is from Bryson Tiller. Do you listen to Bryson Tiller at all?
Every once in a while, okay. I'll hear a song by him that's
and you're like,
super
oh,
hot. Yeah.
Okay, great. Yeah. Awesome. This is off of his new album, which is Anniversary. I promise I will do a reaction. I had so many people telling me I needed to do it, and I will. I promise.
When did it come out?
Yesterday.
Oh.
I just...
All right.
I just... Obviously, I don't have my normal filming setup, so this is gonna... I don't know when it's gonna happen, but it'll happen. But this is the Bryson Tiller track featuring Drake, and it's called Outta Time.
Okay.
So, between Bryson Tiller and Drake, I'm just ready to be in my feels. I'm sorry if it's quiet. We're trying to not wake up the sleeping nephew right now.
Yeah. That's the most important thing.
I was gonna say, that is the priority.
Of the day.
Okay, this is Outta Time.
Maybe things were never the way we made them out to be. How we thought they were. Lately, I'm
I always think
sure. One thing for sure is when we're together.
Oh, he's doing that. Like,
toxic as ever.
He's doing like singing
rapping. Be together.
So here for this beat.
Still play into your palm, even though I know what you want. Been twisted of you so long. Oh, cause it's complicated, far from simple. Always find a way to dodge these issues. Can't seem to shake it out for nothing. Things just can't be fixed without a time.
Almost like early 2000s Miguel-ish.
Oh, okay. I appreciate that.
Yeah?
I appreciate that, yes. Okay, so I lied. We have 11 songs. Next track is another one that was really requested. This is Demi Lovato, Still Have Me.
Oh.
I think this is her breakup track with her ex, and I haven't read any of the drama about it yet.
I mean, I love Demi, so.
I love Demi too, but like, she just got engaged and had like the most beautiful engagement, like on the beach. Her ring was gorgeous. And then within like, I think a couple months,
yikes.
Okay, this is Still Have Me. Pianos fuck me up. Oh, fuck.
I'm a mess and I'm still broken. But I'm finding my way back. All the light I ever had, like the world disappeared, and I'm laying right.
the silence is piercing and it hurts to breathe.
It's a short track.
I don't have much, but at least I still have me.
Oh.
I still have me.
Oh my God.
Everything around me shattered.
What happened?
That's brutal.
All the highs are not just
breakup. I need a reputable source. I've decided to go their separate ways to focus on their respective careers. What does he do?
I don't want to hear that adult explanation.
A little selfie with no ring. Cute. Oh, apparently Max's self-promotion was an issue.
Oh.
In the beginning, Max was super careful about self-promotion and things with his career, but once they got engaged, he really hit the gas pedal and wanted to make the most out of his career opportunities.
Oh.
He felt more comfortable doing so after they were fiancés, and he had a little bit more of a leg up. Okay, so he wanted some clout.
So he exploited her to grow his career. What does he do?
I don't know.
Exactly.
Oh, he's an actor, singer, and dancer.
Oh, well.
He was in The Young and the Restless. Oh, and he was on The Path.
Hmm. So he's a leech, is what we're saying. Right? Right?
I guess that's...
That's why they broke up, right?
Oh, his intentions weren't genuine.
Yeah. No, dude's a dirtbag. Sorry, not sorry, I guess. I don't know. Sorry, not sorry.
Guys, that's what you mean. Damn.
Tough.
Yo.
Oh, well, next song.
I hope I never get famous. Next track is actually from Leslie Odom Jr.
Oh, I can't
wait. It's Leslie Odom Jr. and it's featuring Sia. This is Cold.
I'm excited.
I know, me too. I've heard this is really great. I reacted to Sia on a previous New Music Friday and I think she's just gonna be a staple. Every time she releases new music, she will be on this series. Okay, all right.
You left yourself on empty promises.
His voice. Oh.
I low-key want to go back and listen to it again now.
The harmonies through the whole thing were incredible.
And then that key change
And then the last set of harmonies on the last chorus.
Beautiful.
Insane.
Stunning. Incredible. Amazing. Flawless. Perfect. Next track is Jessie Reyez. This is featuring Eminem. The track is called Cold.
Yeah, I don't know anything about Jessie Reyez.
She's wonderful. She actually just put out an album. I reacted to one of her singles last week, and I'm gonna do a full album reaction to this.
Cool.
Because she really is amazing. Like, her voice is beautiful. And I know you like Eminem, right?
Yeah, I mean, he's probably greatest of all time, but he's good. I like him. Jessie Reyez traditionally like a.
We fought until the sun rose.
It was like Jessie J kind of vibe.
And I still ain't been to bed. And while you got your eyes closed, the devil wakes up in my head.
I want to go learn this.
I write a little note out. Suicidal love roulette. You make me wanna jump off the roof, cause I love.
I'm curious how Eminem is gonna fit into this.
Sounds like a fucked up love song.
Yeah. Okay. So like toxic relationship song, insert Eminem here.
Yep.
Tie you to a bed and set the house on fire. Bury myself with you. I liked his feature, but it was.
I liked it here. I liked it a lot. It was very authentic to Eminem.
For sure.
I wouldn't have thought to put them together. I would not have thought to put her sound and Eminem in the same song. But it worked.
I think it did work. I just don't know if I'm a big fan of it. I don't know. Like, it's almost like a typecast for him.
I mean...
But... I respect it. I like her. I like the music.
Yeah.
I enjoyed all the music.
That guitar tone throughout the track was
that was really nice.
Beautiful. Mm-hmm. And her vocals are gorgeous. Mm-hmm. The next track is from LMA. LMA is one of my favorite, like, R&B artists. She's just... She's beautiful. She's talented.
Yeah.
Her music is always incredible. I keep her in the category with, like, Kalani and Kiana Lade and her and SZA. Like, she's a fave. She's one of my favorites. Okay, the track is called Not Another Love Song.
You're okay. Juxtaposition to the last relationship song we listened to. It's really beautiful. Real sappy.
Her voice makes me think of Mahalia, who is an artist from London.
Okay.
So, like, they don't necessarily sound exactly the same, but it's the same kind of vibe. I think R&B is just my favorite music. Because it's just, like, you just hits you right here.
Mm-hmm.
You feel it in your soul.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm, 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 mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I like.
Girl, hit me with the album. Let's go. She's only put out one album before, and it was in 2018. So she had a few EPs before that, and I think it might be time for another album. Okay, the next track is from Bishop Briggs. This is Higher. Have you listened to Bishop Briggs?
No. Mm-hmm. Never.
Higher, your love is set me free.
Oh, never mind. Okay. Higher.
Drop.
Shave my head and dance with girls you like.
Because she's so, oh my god, she's so fucking underrated. It hurts.
Where is she?
It hurts. Yeah, but one thing I really love about her is she's been very, like, she's super transparent about, like, her journey through the music industry and,
cool.
like, her mental health through it all. I just love her. I love her so much.
Yeah. So much. Oh, she sounds phenomenal.
All right, so now we're getting into the two tracks from last week that I missed completely. The first one is from Sia. This is called Courage to Change, and it's from the motion picture and music. All right, strings. What is that, a violin? What is that? Cello? Cello.
World, I want to leave you better. I want my life to matter. I am afraid I have no purpose here. I watch the news on TV. Abandon myself daily. Pardon me, the rain it falls, rain it falls. So I'm deceived to live and hope, live and love. We don't have this day, stuck in the world. You're not alone, I'm out of this. You're not alone,
she's a musical freight train.
Yes, that was amazing.
Yeah, it was incredible.
Okay, so apparently this is from a motion picture. A motion picture called Music that she wrote.
Okay.
Starring Kate Hudson.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Oh, and she's directing the movie as well.
Nice. She's multi-talented.
The bitch is a genius. Okay, so it's going to star Kate Hudson and Leslie Odom Jr.
Cool.
That was so good. I love the instrumentation throughout it, like from the pianos to, it opened with the cello, right?
Yeah, it was a cello or a violin or something.
Yeah, it opened.
Or both. I don't know.
The next track is one from The Weeknd that I guess I missed. Guess I didn't realize.
Don't know how that happened.
I have no idea how that happened. But this is King of the Fall.
I'm add it up, I just need a plate for breakfast. Put it in a cup, then I mix it up with Texas. Just feeling heavy like I'm rigid on my legs. My bitches that we came with got all of your bitches jealous. Driving by the streets we used to walk through like a triumph.
I feel like being the same face every time I hear The Weeknd is just... music is just thick.
Nothing else can get me high. Yeah.
So I was like, what the fuck? What is happening? And this is the part where all the EXO fans are going to come for my neck because they're going to be like, oh, you're not real EXO. I get it. I know, but I still fucking love this music. So come at me. This was from the Kissland era. This is from like 2014.
This song?
The whole song. Yeah. This was released and it was on SoundCloud, but it was not available on streaming platforms.
Interesting.
So... that's why I'm like, this sounds like I know this song. I fucking know this song. And I was like, this does not sound like the current era of Abel because it's not. I'm into it.
Yeah, I mean.
It's very Weeknd.
Yeah, very.
It's very signature Weeknd.
Braggadocious and like super braggadocious. showing love to the people that he came up with, I guess. And then...
And love to the fans.
And love to the fans. And then talking about how he trains his girls to swallow. So
make them all swallow.
Yeah.
That's how it goes.
All right. I mean, I like the music, though.
Yeah. He's just got that signature sound with all of his music that's... You just can't not hear The Weeknd.
Yeah. It might be a little controversial, but I almost hear a little bit of Michael.
Oh, yeah. I mean, he's got that, like...
yeah, he has his own tone, but...
Yeah. But it still kind of has that almost like a rasp to it. I don't know how to describe it.
I mean, it'd be totally... But... Oh, well.
Listen, your thoughts are your thoughts. Whatever. Well, thanks for hanging out with me.
Yeah,
that's all we have. Yeah. That's New Music Friday. That's it. Thank you so much for coming and hanging out with us today. I'm really excited to give you this reaction. Definitely going to be adding some of this music to my Every Fucking Day playlist. So you can find that on Apple Music and on Spotify. I've got links in the description below, as well as all of my social media. You probably don't want
to. I don't care. You can follow me if you want.
I'll put his social media in the handle below.
Yeah.
He and I both kind of pop off on Twitter every now and then.
So. That's, yeah.
So, I think your Instagram is private though, right?
Yeah, Instagram is private.
Yeah, so don't be creeping
on. Got the kiddo on there.
Don't be creeping on his family, all right?
Yeah. No, you can follow me on Twitter though.
Yeah, I'll link his Twitter below with mine. But that's really it. Thank you so much for joining us for this video. I hope I get to see you in the next one. You say hello to the internet.
Oh my gosh. Say hello all to the internet. Puppies.
This is Bailey.
Bailey. She looks like a wet rat.
That's gonna be a lot of fun to edit.
Just all my faces. Yes. There's all four of your like whatever.
The thumbnails?
Oh yeah, all the thumbnails.
We'll take a few thumbnail pictures afterwards too. I had it on the playlist and okay, next track is I'm fine. You should see me film alone. It's bad.